Hello, welcome to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari.
Let us walk in the steps of the divines.
Today we're going to be reading the Song of Pelinal, Volume 4. We are in the Temple of the Divines, and I found this book in the Temple of Kinnerath. The Song of Pelinal, Volume 4, On His Deeds. Editor's Note. Volumes 1 through 6 are taken from the so-called Remen manuscript located in the Imperial Library. It is a transcription of older fragments collected by an unknown scholar of the early Second Era. Beyond this, little is known of the original sources of these fragments, some of which appear to be from the same period, perhaps even the same manuscript. But, as no scholarly consensus yet exists on dating these 6 fragments, no opinions will be offered here. Pelinal drove the sorcerer armies past the Nibin, claiming all the eastern lands for the rebellion of the Paravania, and Kine had to send her rain to wash the blood from the villages and forts that no longer flew alien banners, for the armies of men needed to make camps of them as they went forward. And he broke the doors open for the prisoners of the Vatash, with the slave king flying as Morahouse above them, and men called her Al-Esh for the first time. He entered the gate at, to win back the hands of the thousand strong of Sedor, a tribe now unknown but famous in those days, which the aliens had stolen in the night, 2,000 hands that he brought back in a wagon made of demon bone, whose wheels trailed the sound of women when ill at heart. Text loss. And after the first pogrom, which consolidated the northern holdings for the men of Creeth, he stood with white hair gone brown with elf blood at the bridge of Haldon, where Perif's falconers had sent for the Nords, and they, looking at him, said that Shor had returned, but he spat at their feet for profaning that name. He led them anyway into the heart of the hinterland west, to drive the aliens inward towards the Tower of White Gold, a slow retreating circle that could not understand the power of man's sudden liberty, and what fury idea that brought. His mace crushed the thundernocks that Umaral sent as harriers on the rebellion's long march back south and east, and carried Morahouse Breath of Kine to Zuathus the Clever Cutting Man, a need with a Kepdu name, for healing when the bull had fallen to a volley of bird beaks. And of course, at the Council of Skiffs, where all of the Paravania's armies and all of the Nords shook with fear at the storming of White Gold, so much so that the Al-Esh herself counseled delay, Pelinal grew furious and made names of Umaral, and made names of what cowards he thought he saw around him, and then made for the tower by himself, for Pelinal often acted without thought. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Skyrim, The Song of Pelinal, Volume 4.